Welcome back, everybody. In today's session, we are moving back to the Trials Fusion. We had just found some very interesting things in the Trials Fusion with the Wipeout 3 by WidzTonik. Closest I'm going to get to that. Sorry if I mispronounce your names. These maps are amazing. We appreciate this. We're going to be starting out with Wipeout 3, and I'm handing the controller over to Max to take this one on. And, of course, the only way to do this is with the Pit Viper.
All right, good. I don't have to ride the goddamn donkey.
No. It's...
More of you can't do it with the donkey?
You can. It's quite challenging. I myself have actually run through Wipeout 3 and 4, so I wanted to give Max the benefit of doubt of freshly coming into this because it is an entertaining map set.
I didn't see your name on it, though. I just saw Green's.
I ran it under Green's account.
Very convenient.
It was.
And it most was, extreme elimination.
It was Green and I who were actually running these things together. So he did 4 and I did 3.
Oh, good lord.
Oh, yeah. As I said, these maps are fantastic.
Oh, good god. All right.
Just gun it on the first one and ramp over all into the red one. You just gotta hit it with your back wheel and you're good.
All right.
Watch your head on these, though. Sometimes they'll hit. I didn't mean pop a wheelie and do it that way.
I tried to, but...
Sorry, I'll stop ruining the course. That's what I meant. That'll be my last tidbit of help, so I want you to feel the full experience of this.
Well, that's a little unfair.
Well, I mean, it's a quite entertaining map. It's very enjoyable. It's definitely a good breather from the I've been running, but it's still very entertaining to watch. And
oh, come on. That's crap.
This map is very well done.
But that little very slight noggin hit is a little ridiculous.
Yeah, but you get used to it to kind of just take it a little bit slow.
Nope.
You got it. Just push it up as best you can. There you go. Now you're done with that.
Ah!
This is an entertaining part too.
Oh shit! That's fun.
Nope. Yep. You have to ride that thing down. It took us forever to figure that out, but still. And then you have to.
I was like, if I gun it, I got it.
Time these appropriately. Oh, we see what I mean. This map is beautiful.
All right,
this was definitely worth putting on the channel.
Yep.
So to all our Trials Fusion fans, we do highly recommend these games. It's under the Track Central under Skill Games for Wipeout 3 and 4.
Knocking my mic all over the place here. dead.
If you do find some of this entertainment, please do comment, because this is honestly hilarious to me.
All right. I think the roach would be a little easier.
It would, but me and Green actually did this on the Pit Viper, so we wanted you to experience it the same way we did.
Yeah, adds a layer of challenge.
Yeah, because it's very jumpy.
Yeah.
And
not as bad as the damn donkey. The donkey would just make it aggravating.
Yeah, there is an extreme part at the end, which you will understand why I didn't want you to go on the donkey.
Oh! Damn, I bat had it. Get out of there.
Oh, you're fine. Just nicking your back wheel. There you go. Doing it beautifully. And...
Should have just gunned it there.
But, I actually found this as just stumbling on some of the stumbling on some of the skill maps, and we were trying to do some challenges and set some records, and we just stumbled across this one. And we loved the show Wipeout when it was on, especially like the hilarious commentary and stuff that they had. So we tried it out, and I thought it would be fantastic for you to run on the channel, and you see why.
Did you see Most Extreme Elimination?
Yeah.
Oh,
why the one where
that?
they do like the dub over the Japanese version.
Yeah. I liked that more than Wipeout.
Wipeout was just like the American version of that.
Damn it.
That. But it's still a very, very entertaining show. I guess it's just human nature to laugh at people getting injured. Nice.
Got
there
it.
You go. And now you're
I got
on
the balls. I got the balls. I got the balls.
Ah. I think this was the only thing that we did flawlessly.
I just nice. Got that.
This isn't too bad. I think most of this is a pretty much gunning. You kind of have the gun section. Gung ho. Except for the next part.
Get over there. Oh, I always hate this.
No! You got it. Pop it back. There you go. Now you're at it. Nicely done. And yeah, this part's not too terrible. It's just more of a smooth rolling. The pyramid can get a little difficult, and you can get decapitated. Well, not literally decapitated, but you see what I mean. You get hit like that if you don't excel over the pyramid fast enough. But yeah, we have no idea why we decided to go with a Pit Viper at first. We were, you know, with the other skill games that we were running that night, it was actually you needed it. So we were like, oh, we definitely need it for this.
And go.
That part right there actually took me forever. This part
damn
is
it. I thought I had it.
This part's a big struggle too. There is a high pattern on it that you'll have to figure out. Let's see. Luckily, the reason why Green's got the record on this one is because he had to see the misery of what I went through to get this, and he figured out the pattern. But still, this is definitely a nice little smooth run right there.
Oh, I got lucky
yeah,
there.
Yeah, you did. How did that not hit you?
I guess because I leaned forward. Oh, shit. Didn't expect that.
And this part, yeah, throwing out the blocks and stuff.
Damn.
Yep. Oh, now that's going to be really tough for you to get through. Oh, I lied.
Not really. Barely an inconvenience.
And you still crash. Yeah, this part I didn't find too terribly difficult if you just kind of... Yeah, not really like that, but... It's kind of hard to not, like, give away hints of what you need to do.
Damn.
You're close to it, though.
Slow and steady wins the race, it seems.
Yeah, but you don't want to let them get down there at the bottom. You kind of just want to plow through them and let them go by you. Just constantly just hold your gas slowly and just keep moving forward through the blocks. Don't gun it. But well, you'll push through them slowly. Trust me, they'll push away from you. You don't really have to lean forward because you're not going
to
really...
I tried to.
Oh. Now you're stuck in there. Yeah, they get near the bottom. This part was the one I made it through relatively easily in.
Ow.
It was that punching bag thing that you made it through a lot faster than both of us did is what I got stuck on. Nice.
Oh.
And you
splash.
But you see what I mean? The intricacy and stuff that they put into this.
No, they've done a really good job. Yeah.
But yeah, they've done a really good job in everything they did with this. And for what you'll see in 4, it's a really cool thing that they did. And you'll see that near the end of 4 once we put that on.
Well, what about Wipeouts 1 and 2? Did y'all do those? Or
I couldn't find 1 and 2. The only one, because this was under the popular skill challenges, was 3 and 4. And it was getting really late, so we didn't. We didn't really try to search for 1 and 2, but we might.
Well, it looked like when you typed in it looked like when you typed in Wipeout.
Yeah, it came up, but we didn't really use the search feature.
Okay, why am I getting wiped out there?
Didn't use the search feature. We were just going under skill games and just randomly came across this. This is it. I love that part. Yep, that's cool.
That's pretty. That part was pretty easy.
Yeah. Coming up in here, it gets really easy because it knows the part you're about to go into is going to be the biggest pain. And,
Ooh, saved it.
This isn't terrible. Oh. This is relatively easy. Just a minor inconvenience, really.
Actually, barely an inconvenience. Oh.
Okay, and so, yeah, I don't think that's how you do it. Yeah, because you can just notch that down, and if you can land in there, I mean, it seems like a straightforward motion. Just kind of just randomly going over arbitrarily going over those pyramids, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah, and then coming out the other end.
Yeah, and it's not really like a major thing. It's just dropping down, and you're good. This part right here is the part you enjoy. This is the last part of the map. And you'll see you use L1 and R1 to drive the vehicle.
Oh.
But you also have to balance your bike at the same time. So, good luck. Yeah. This is the part that
separates the men from the boys.
It definitely separates the men from the boys, and the part that almost separated my controller in half. So... It was a very, especially with a pit viper and how bouncy it is, which is why we're like, if we really want to set a record, we'd probably go with something like the Roach or the Baggy.
Right.
Got it. No, you have to stay on it all the way through it. And it's, you're driving it as you're going.
Well, because I want to go fast.
I will say this is not a speed thing you can do.
Yeah.
This is slow and steady. This is definitely a tortoise game right here. And you'll learn the balancing factor to it. And, yeah, it was pretty entertaining. The worst part is I made it all the way to the end with this and messed up the jump and had to redo it again.
Ah!
So, as he's at a fantastic 69 faults. All right, now you need to finish it.
Yep.
All right, do this flawlessly. Take your time. And unfortunately, I guess I have to get on my account and actually try to set something up there as well. So at least get my name matched up there in the friends list.
Go.
But yeah, it's hard to try to like double up your throttle control.
It is.
Leading into like the L1 and the... Yep.
Damn.
And not trying to flip this damn pit viper.
You would think, like, in real life, I feel like this wouldn't be difficult.
Yeah.
But you can't just lock the brake and do it. If you lock the brake, you go in reverse.
You can't just, like, set your feet down either.
Right?
So, if you could set your feet down, then you could just haul tail through here and just run it flawlessly.
Why is this thing not going forward?
You have to hit it fast enough to go over these larger humps. That's the thing. And you don't have to go all the way back, but you do have to hit it fast enough to bump over while still doing throttle control. That's where it gets difficult. And these are you're in the last few stages right here, and this is the one you have to have the power and stuff behind. But, yeah, it was,
Shit!
This is why I wanted you to do 3 first to experience this one. 4 has a little bit easier finish, but I think it's a lot cooler, cleaner finish. And you'll probably see what I mean probably next episode, more than likely. But this has still been quite entertaining to me. And compared to some of the maps that we have run on this, especially with the donkey, this is definitely more enjoyable to run, in my opinion. Ooh, nice. Let's back this one up a little bit. This is the last hump right here. You make it over this hump and that vertical little grind right there, and you're good.
Alright, come on, baby. Come on.
You got it. Just take it forward and make it over that hump. Come on, just push it. You gotta hit R1.
I am. It's not going either way.
Is it not?
Nah. Fuck.
It shouldn't be stuck. Oh man, you must have hit like a weird glitch spot. That is the tail end part of it.
Okay.
And
cool.
You go right over it.
Oh, you know, I was trying to break, but I was hitting L1 and R1 at the same time.
Yeah, no, that doesn't. That'll make it not go.
Yeah.
So you made it all the way to the end and then did that. Oh, you were actually balling through that up until that point.
Right.
So. Yeah, it looks like you got a little bit of control in there. Not bad. But you see what I mean, where if it was like with the baggy or the roach, you could probably just straight up ball through this.
Yeah.
Because you wouldn't be sitting there popping.
The donkey. The donkey. This would be a goddamn
That's
nightmare.
That's why I didn't want to actually put you on the donkey on this. I wanted you to enjoy the map instead of that. Woo! Just make it over this. Yep, there it is. Nope, hold it. Yep. And drive it all the way to the end. Nope, you've got to drive it all the way to the end. That's exactly what I did.
I was like, it'll be easier to do it that way. Should have listened.
Yeah, that was what I did when I made it in there. I was like, I didn't know you could drive it all the way to the end. I thought that was the end. And
I just thought I could make the jump.
I feel like you probably could, but it just kind of takes some...
Got to do it right.
Yeah. You were actually doing a lot better control than what we did on this thing. We took this thing slow and steady.
I'm constantly tapping back or reverse and holding back.
Yeah. It may be a good way we can do it without the faults.
Yay!
There it is. There is Wipeout 3.
Silver medal.
Kind of hope you all enjoyed this map. We know this video's been a little short, but we will pick back up with Wipeout 4. Come back and see us next week. If you like the content, as always, hit the like button, subscribe, and click that bell for notifications. Appreciate you guys showing out.
Bye, everybody.
Oh, didn't see you there. Let me know down in the comments if you enjoyed those guys. I just signed them on, and I'm not sure they got what it takes to make it on YouTube. But if you did like the video, like it, and subscribe to their channel. That way, they can make me more money. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go and annoy a prince. Ciao!